Hello everyone, let's learn today features and attachment of the clavicle. Now here I have right clavicle in my hand, and as you know it has got two ends, medial end or sternal end and lateral end or acromial end and intervening shaft. Now the shaft is concave or convex, so in medial 2/3 it is convex in front, in lateral 1/3 it is convex behind, and the meeting point of these two is considered as the weakest spot, which is likely to be fractured when we fall on outstretched hand. Now let's see the medial end. As I mentioned, it is broad expanded end and it is related to the clavicular notch of the manubrium sterni. Now let me show you. This is entire sternum. This upper portion is called as manubrium sterni. Lower portion is the body of sternum. So in the upper part or in the manubrium sterni, in the midline you can see a notch. This is termed as suprasternal notch. And on either side of that, there are two notches. Now this is termed as the clavicular notch. So here lies the medial end of the clavicle. Let me show you. So this is medial end or sternal end. And these two, along with the first costal cartilage from below, these three together will form sternoclavicular joint, which is a saddle variety of synovial joint. And as you know, three structures, the clavicle, manubrium and first costal cartilage, these three are forming this joint, so it is called as compound variety of joint. And again, the joint cavity is divided into two compartments by an articular disc, which is made up of fibrocartilage. So now the joint is complex variety. So sternoclavicular joint is compound complex saddle variety of synovial joint. Now let's see the attachments on the medial end. Now in upper part there is attachment of interclavicular ligament over here. Now what is interclavicular ligament? The name itself is suggestive of it is connecting both the clavicles together. Now let me show you. This is left clavicle, this is right clavicle, and in between these two will be the interclavicular ligament. And as we have discussed, there will be suprasternal notch in the midline. So here. So the interclavicular ligament will be observed in the suprasternal, and this ligament is holding both the clavicles together, so they will not separate out. It prevents separation of both the clavicles. Now another attachment on the medial end, posterior superior to the medial end, over here behind the interclavicular ligament, over here will be attachment of the fibrocartilaginous articular disc. As we have discussed, it will divide the joint cavity into two compartments. So over here will be articular disc, and below it is attached to the sternum and the first costal cartilage. So it will divide the joint cavity into meniscoclavicular compartment and meniscosternal compartment. All around the medial end, it is providing attachment to the joint capsule of the sternoclavicular joint. Now let's see the shaft. The shaft is concave or convex. The medial 2/3 is prismatic or cylindrical, and it has got four surfaces: superior surface, anterior surface, the inferior surface and posterior surface. Four surfaces. Now the anterior surface in its medial half over here, it provides origin to the clavicular head of pectoralis major. On the superior surface, on its medial 1/3 over here, this will provide attachment to sternocleidomastoid. The name itself is suggestive of the muscle takes origin from two bones, sternum and clavicle. Cleido means clavicle. So sternocleidomastoid. Mastoid is the point of insertion. So the muscle takes origin from below and it is inserted above to the mastoid process. So the clavicular head of sternocleidomastoid, it is taking origin from the superior surface along its medial 1/3. Now inferior surface, you can see over here in its medial part or medial 1/3, it is rough and it is in relation to the first costal cartilage and first rib, and in between these two there is a ligament called as costoclavicular ligament. Costa means rib, so a ligament that connects first costal cartilage to the undersurface of the clavicle, the name is given to it is costoclavicular ligament. Now next to this notch, in the undersurface, approximately in the middle 1/3, there is a groove, and this is termed as subclavian groove. The groove provides attachment to subclavius muscle. It has got two lips, the outer lip and inner lip, and the margins of the lip are providing attachment to clavipectoral fascia. So basically the clavipectoral fascia, it is enclosing subclavius muscle. Now the posterior surface, in its medial part over here, it provides attachment to sternohyoid muscle. It is one of the infrahyoid muscle. So that is taking origin from over here. And the medial portion, posterior surface, here it is related to the termination of subclavian vein and internal jugular vein. So from over here, there will be commencement of brachiocephalic vein. And lateral to that, this portion is related to the subclavian artery, third part, and the trunks of brachial plexus. Now lateral one third of the shaft, as we have discussed, it is flattened from above downward. So it has got anterior border, posterior border, superior surface and inferior surface. The anterior border, it provides origin to anterior fibers of deltoid. The deltoid has got three fibers. Let me connect the clavicle with the scapula. So this is how it is connected. And along the anterior border of lateral one third, from over here the anterior fibers of the deltoid are taking origin. And then comes this acromion process. So along its lateral border, the middle fibers, and it is continuous as lower lip of crest of spinoscapula. So over here, along with this, there will be origin of posterior fibers of deltoid. So deltoid takes origin like this. Anterior fiber from clavicle, middle fibers from the acromion process, and posterior fibers from the spinous process. Now the posterior border of lateral one third, over here, this border is receiving insertion of the trapezius. So again, like deltoid, the trapezius is inserted to posterior border of the lateral one third, then the fibers are inserted to the medial border of the acromion process, and then to the upper lip of crest of spinoscapula. So all around there will be insertion of trapezius inside in the inner concavity, and outside there will be origin of deltoid. So two muscles are attached, over here will be deltoid and over here will be the trapezius. The upper surface, it is subcutaneous, and in the under surface at the junction of medial two third and lateral one third, there is a tubercle. Over here you can see this tubercle is called as conoid tubercle because it is providing attachment to a ligament. The shape of the ligament is cone like. So this is conoid tubercle, and anterolateral to that tubercle there is a rough area or a ridge, and this is called as trapezoid ridge. Now trapezoid ridge, again it provides attachment to a ligament. The shape of the ligament is trapezoid, so as the name given to this ridge is trapezoid ridge. Now these two together, conoid tubercle and trapezoid ridge, these two together provide attachment to coracoclavicular ligament. The name itself is suggestive of the ligament is attaching or connecting coracoid process and the clavicle. Let me show you. So the lateral end will be connecting with the acromion process, and if you connect both like this, so the undersurface of the lateral one third will be in relation to the coracoid process. This is beak like coracoid process, and between these two there is a ligament termed as coracoclavicular ligament. Now this ligament has got two parts, conoid part and trapezoid part. The conoid part, it is cone shaped, and the apex of the cone is attached to the root of the coracoid process near suprascapular notch over here, and above to the conoid tubercle that we have discussed. So that is the attachment of conoid part. And lateral to that, over the superior surface of coracoid process, there will be attachment of trapezoid part below, and that is attached above to the trapezoid ridge. So the coracoclavicular ligament, it has got two part, conoid part and trapezoid part. The trapezoid part is trapezoid in shape, the conoid part is cone shaped. There is a peculiarity of this coracoclavicular ligament. You know, the scapula is attached to the humerus. So the weight comes from humerus to the scapula from the upper extremity, and from the scapula the weight is transmitted to the coracoid process, then to this ligament, coracoclavicular ligament, and this is how the weight from scapula is shifted to the clavicle, to its medial two-third, and from over here, from sternoclavicular joint, the weight is shifted to the sternum or the axial skeleton. So the coracoclavicular ligament is very important in weight transmission. Now let's see lateral end of the clavicle. As you know, it is flattened end and it has got a flat articular surface which is oval in shape, and this will be articulating with its corresponding articular surface on the anterior part of medial border of the acromion process. Over here you can see there is a similar flattened articular facet. So these two will be articulated like this, and together they form a plain variety of acromioclavicular joint between acromion process and clavicle. It is plain synovial joint permitting gliding movements only. Now the articular surface all around, it provides attachment to the joint capsule, and sometimes it may have an articular disc inside, but whenever it is present it is generally pierced. So that is regarding acromioclavicular joint. Now in the chart we have discussed that the anterior surface of middle third, over here it provides origin to pectoralis major, and over here anterior border lateral one third will be providing origin to the deltoid. So the portion of shaft between the pectoralis major and deltoid over here, this will be forming boundary of deltopectoral triangle through which the cephalic vein passes through it. And one more thing is, along the shaft four important muscles are attached. Over here will be pectoralis major to its anterior surface medially, and laterally over here will be deltoid. Similarly, on its superior surface medially there is attachment of sternocleidomastoid, and posteriorly over here in the lateral one third there is attachment of trapezius. So between these four muscles, the anterior surface and superior surface, it is subcutaneous and it is covered by skin and platysma. And within subcutaneous tissue, we also get supraclavicular nerves, which are branches of the cervical plexus. The root value is C2 and C3. Now another thing regarding shaft is, over here will be sternocleidomastoid in its superior surface, and over here will be trapezius along its posterior border, lateral third. So the shaft of the clavicle between sternocleidomastoid and the trapezius over here, this portion or middle third of the clavicle will be forming boundary of posterior triangle. Now you know the medial two-third of the shaft is cylindrical and lateral one-third is flattened from above downward. It is just because the medial two-third, it helps in weight transmission via coracoclavicular ligament to the sternum, whereas the flattened lateral one-third, it is suspending the scapula because of the coracoclavicular ligament. So that is about clavicle or collarbone. The literal meaning of clavicle is key because the shape is like a key, so as the name given to it. Hope you understood well. Thanks for watching.